Hello, fans, and welcome back to another Ice Lions game. I'm your lead commentator, Stephen Pepper, and
I'm Katie Knoll.
And today we are getting a little up close and personal with some of the teammates, team members here. We're going to interview them, get to know them a little bit better, and how they're feeling about these next two games.
I'm Katie Knoll here with Zach Good. So what position are you playing right now?
I'm a defenseman.
And how long have you been on the team?
I'm a freshman right now.
First year?
Yes, first year.
Okay, you guys are coming off of some losses in a row. How are you guys planning on bouncing back from them?
I think we're trying to build our team chemistry right now. On Monday, we had a practice where it was two teams doing battle drills. That really got the guys moving again. So hopefully this weekend we can bring it and give Drexel and Ryder a run for their money.
What are you guys changing about your plays, your strategy to try to win?
We're trying to be quicker with our plays, especially here. In this drill, you can see the D moving their puck with one-touch passes. Just overall trying to be quicker.
All right, so I'm here with Dayton Collins, part of the ACHA hockey team for PSU. So we just want to kind of get to know you a little bit better. So what's your journey been like through hockey? How long have you played and how'd you get started?
I've been playing for like 15-ish years. I grew up in Florida, so I played down there. Just a couple organizations. Always played up north, and I guess I just found my way here, so.
Nice. Pretty long distance to come all the way up here, yeah. So during Christmas break, you guys had some relaxation time, then you came back and you had your first two games away against Liberty, and it was both a loss. So what do you guys think were could have done better during that game?
I don't know. I think we just kind of, like you said, it was after a break, so it's kind of tough getting right back into it. And Liberty's, like, they got a great program, so it's definitely definitely kind of tough going in and losing, but there's a lot of positives. We're right there with them, so I think we'll get them next time we play them.
Nice. And you got two games coming up this weekend. Friday you got Drexel, and Saturday you got Ryder. So these are two teams you have not faced yet this season. So how are you feeling going into those?
I'm excited. I mean, we can't take anyone lightly, but I don't know. Hopefully we'll be able to get back in our win column. So
yeah. Dayton, thank you very much for coming out. Best luck for the games coming up.
Thanks, guys.
So we have Henry Silo here answering a few questions for us about this weekend. So after the two losses from Liberty, how are you feeling about moving on to these next few games?
Well, it sucked to lose, but we need to get a reset and just look on to the next game and try to play better and play as a team and play hard and have a drive to win.
Have a drive to win. Nice. I forgot to mention. So we just want to get to know you a little bit better, our fans at home. So what's your journey been like through at hockey? How long have you played and what got you to start?
Yeah, so I'm originally Finnish, and I've moved around a lot. So I've lived in London and Paris where I played hockey, which was a little different because the hockey level there wasn't as great. But I played with older kids, and then I ended up here as a Ryan Chu are about the only foreigners here, so I'm representing here.
That's awesome. So after the last two games, you suffered two losses. That kind of made the record that you guys had a little bit tighter. So is the pressure a little bit more on for you guys compared to your last few games, and how are you guys handling it?
Well, we know we have a great team, and we know what we can do. It's just we need to get our things together and play as a team, and if we do that, I feel like we can beat anyone.
All right. Thank you, Henry, for your time, best luck for the next games.
I'm Katie Knoll here with Josh Ferry. So how long have you been playing hockey?
Since I was in third grade.
How are you guys preparing for two different teams back-to-back in 1 week?
Honestly, in practice right now, we're working on special teams a lot. We had a big battle day yesterday. We really just got to come out and play a structured game, and we'll be fine. Doesn't matter who we play.
What are you guys changing after coming off of two losses back-to-back?
Again, I think the problem was the structure, for sure. The team we played, I don't think, was more skilled than we were, but they definitely played a more organized game, and we lost because of that, I think.
How do you guys feel coming back to your home ice after a while being at away games?
It's nice. It's great to play at home. It's a lot more familiar, and we've done pretty well here so far.
Okay. Thank you for your time. Thanks.
So what's your journey been like with hockey? When have you started, and how long have you played?
I started playing at 6 years old, house league, basically. Then I started playing travel around 7 years old. Played travel up until I was 16. Then I went to boarding school for 2 years, and then came to Penn State.
All right, nice. So to break the elephant in the room, it's been Christmas break. You had your first two games away at Liberty, and you unfortunately lost both. So how are you feeling after that?
I think it's definitely tough for us to get our legs back. You know, we came back on Sunday, Only had a couple of practices to get ready. Liberty had played the weekend before. I think we just need to keep coming to the rink and showing up, and I think we'll get the results we need.
All right, yeah. So leaving that as it is, you got two home games coming up this week. You play Drexel in 2 days on Friday, and then you also play Ryder the next day. So what's going through your mind? What's the team doing to prepare for that challenge up ahead?
I think we've been trying to raise the compete level in our practices. Monday's practice was all battle drills. Everyone's been getting in the gym. And we know we can handle Drexel and Ryder, so we've just been playing our usual game and prepping as we usually do.
All right, and after those two losses, you kind of, the record got a little bit tighter than last time. So is the pressure like hitting you guys now, or how are you feeling going to these because of that? How are you handling it?
There's definitely more pressure. It's a must-win situation right now, at least to get into regionals. Like I said, I think we have the confidence that we can handle these two teams. We just need to bring our A game.
All right, thanks, Nate. We wish you the best of luck this Friday and Saturday.
Thank you.
Yep. I'm Michael Smedley here with the team captain for the Penn State Ice Lions, Ryan Long. Ryan, how long, first of all, how long have you been playing hockey? How long have you been with the Ice Lions?
This is my 16th season playing competitive hockey, and then I guess this would technically be my third season with the Ice Lions team, minus the year for COVID last year.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. What is the best part about, and you know, it's been about a month since you guys have played here at Pegula. What is the best part about this weekend getting back on your own ice and your own turf?
I mean, I think like the reason that all the guys on the team are doing this, it's to continue doing something that they've done for their whole life and have fun doing it. It's always a little bit more fun when you get to get out on your home ice, sleep in your own bed. And obviously we're looking to get back in the win column after a rough weekend last weekend. So I know all the guys are kind of eager to get out there.
Yeah, absolutely. Speaking of last weekend, so this weekend you're preparing for two different teams, back-to-back days with nothing, no time in between. What did the practice schedule look like to get ready for two different opponents back-to-back?
So it was kind of the idea on Monday. I think we were lacking kind of our potential last weekend. So did a lot of compete drills, a lot of game-like situations, just try to get the tempo back up. And then, you know, as you guys can see tonight, we're doing a lot of special team system work. Just to kind of get that rolling heading into Friday night.
Awesome. As team captain, last question for you. What is different about the way that you're preparing for this weekend versus the rest of the team? Is there any sort of difference in the way that you're helping to get the guys' mentality back up?
Yeah, I mean, I think the biggest thing is, like, you know, I can talk as much as I want to, but, you know, if I'm not leading by example and not contributing, you know, in our games, you know, I think that looks bad on our team. So I know that, you know, individually, I need to step up, and in doing so, I hope to set an example for the rest of the guys. And, you know, I want everybody to play as a team this weekend, because I think guys have been a little bit too individual lately, including myself. So when we get back to that team mentality, I think we'll start getting in the win column again.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time, Ryan.
Absolutely. Thanks, Michael.
And they finally score. Brendan Mayer making his way forward. A shot from D'Elia. Connolly up the center ice. Someone wipes out in front of him. Gotta love it. Here comes Duncan to D'Elia. A shot, but it's wide. It's a little scramble here, and the puck just goes wide up. With speed, we have De Laurentiis. Shot, and a goal by Iceline's Matt Owens. By Iceland
in the center ice. 91, Justin Strobel. The
2-on-1 advantage here. Let's see what they can do. And they score!
From Pagula Ice Arena in State College, Pennsylvania, this is Penn State Ice Lions Hockey.
Commentator for today, alongside with another additional member to our team, Kyle Smith. Hey, Kyle, tell us a little bit about yourself.
All right, I am a junior studying broadcast journalism at Penn State. Been watching hockey since I was 5 years old. Ready to see how the Ice Lions do today.
Well, Kyle, it's so nice to have you on board, and we're looking forward to seeing you and happy that you could join us this season.
Thank you.
So, friends back home, if you missed the game yesterday, a little recap. It was Drexel versus Ice Lions. First period, Drexel came out of the gates quickly and scored a first goal within like a minute or two of play on the power play. Second period, Ice Lions did the exact same thing. The physicality picked up big time, and the team was so much better. There was a lot of aggression. Five goals were scored between both teams, and that ended with a 3-3 tie by the end of the second period. Third period, same aggression came on, but no goals were scored. A lot of penalties, but no goals. Went to a 3-on-3 overtime, and no one was able to take advantage of the open space, so it forced a shootout. Both teams battled hard, but at the end, it was Karapandy to make the save, and just like that, the Ice Lions now sit at a record of 10-5. So, as I mentioned today, the Ice Lions play again at home against Ryder, and they are so far undefeated at home. Looking forward to seeing how well they do and if they're able to keep that undefeated streak. Now we'll see you just in a little bit. Go grab a drink and come back, and we'll see you real soon. All right, welcome back, fans. As they're getting ready to get back into the game, start finishing their warm-ups, just can't help but talk about yesterday's game and how that went. The Ice Lions were just not able to keep up in the beginnings of the periods, and they just never seemed to take the lead until the shootout. And that's a lot of pressure for them to have when they play a really tough team like Drexel. So for Ryder, Kyle, who do you think will be looked at as the player to be shined upon, someone that's going to lead the team today?
I think the leader of the team today is going to be the captain, Ryan Along. I think the way he hits the ice today will really set the tone for the Ice Lions. They were able to steal the victory last night in the fifth round in a shootout, and they look to win by a pretty big margin today.
Yeah, and this isn't like earlier in the season where they face teams where they're having blowouts of like big numbers. Like I think Maris was 15-0. So the pressure is definitely on. Each team wants it. So how do you think they're handling this right now?
They might be a little nervous, but I think getting the pregame jitters out and the warmups, letting your shots fly, it'll set the tone early on when you get that first big hit on the Ryder team.
I will agree today. Yes, this is going to be a very interesting game to see how it plays out. Like I said earlier, the record still sits at 10-5, so they are still at a very strong spot for a playoff, contending for a playoff spot. But anything is possible. They just got to keep up the determination and show them they mean business. Mm-hmm. Buzzer sounds, and that is the cue that we will start the national anthem. Ryder came out full strength for their warm-ups, so they know they mean business. Unfortunately for fans back home, we do not have our current lineup right away. We're just gonna assume it's yesterday's, so we will update you as we figure that out and go along. Players now take their spots on the blue line to stand for the national anthem. Great way to start every game. There isn't that many fans as yesterday that came out, but we still have a decent turn up to support our Ice Lions. The applause, we get to another game of hockey. As I can see here, it looks like number 31 on the Ice Lions, Joshua Ferry, will be starting today. Kyle, he is a freshman, and he has scored a shutout for him playing, but what's the pressure? What kind of pressure do you think he's feeling as a freshman being started this late in the season?
Oh, as a freshman, I mean, there's tons of pressure. You got to hope that he's trying to relieve it now in the warm-ups, but he has a lot of older guys, a lot of his captains, juniors and seniors. He's going to be playing for them today. He needs to come out big to keep this home undefeated Ice advantage.
Agreed, and Josh really does keep that true. He does have that confidence, and he's ready to start the game. Ugh.
coaches gather around the center circle to start the face-off. And Ryan Long is up and ready to take this first draw. Puck is dropped, and Ryder wins that first one in their defensive zone, keeping it together as Icelines come out with an excellent forecheck in the beginning. Scrambling down, it gets loose, and Icelines pick it up in their defensive zone. Play is stopped, and it looks like there is going to be an offsides.
Offsides on Ryder. They went over the blue line a little bit too early. This puck will drop right outside of the neutral zone.
Both teams seem eager to play. Let's see how more this energy lasts. Win by the Ice Lions in their defensive zone. Up to Schumann. Schumann tries to get it out of the zone, but passes it from the side. A clear, and it goes into neutral ice and hits a few players. Recollected by the Ice Lions. Setting up shop into the neutral zone. Coming in with speed, but it gets turned around in the neutral zone once again. Ryder takes it back, setting up a play. Full across the blue line, and around the boards the puck goes. Ice Lions pick that up, Brendan Mayer. Into the neutral zone to play, and Ryder chases that back down. No one seems to be able to get their hands on the pucks fully today, just like yesterday. Pass around the boards, and the captain for Ryder launches into the neutral zone, but it's pushed back in. Good pass before the blue line, and they dump it into the Ice Lions' territory. Taken back, Ice Lions pick it up with speed. Number 9, Joseph D'Elia, pushes him down. A centering pass, but it goes wide, and his Mayer's not able to get it. And D'Elia is down, struggling to get up. He is down. Slowly getting up.
It looked like he might have chipped his skate on the side and ran right into the boards at full speed, going for the power move cross inside. We gotta hope he's okay.
Yeah, D'Elia is a really good defenseman for this team. I would hate to see him out this early in the game. He is coherent, he is conscious, he's sitting against the board, he is just taking a breather, but he is well and okay. Looks like something happened with the helmet around the head. Tough hit to take early in the first period, wouldn't you say so, Kyle?
Yeah, with barely over a minute in, it looks like he is down, grabbing his head. We're not sure what kind of injury it is, but he looks like he's slowly getting up now.
And he does so. As the crowd applauses, as good sportsmanship arises. Gotta love to see it. We'll keep you updated and see if he comes back, but for now, he is okay. He's skating well, a little wobbly, but he's all right. We're gonna see a face-off on the blue line by the Riders' territory, off to the right by the bleachers. Number 26, Alec Connolly, takes this draw, and Ice Lions win it, but it gets pushed into Ryder territory and they get it out. Picked up by Green, bad pass or dump in there, intercepted by Ryder. They're gonna call this one offsides as well. Ice Lions, there's too many people across the blue line.
Ice Lions look like they're doing a good job forechecking, trying to apply pressure early to Ryder. They just can't seem to get control of the puck in Ryder's zone.
Maybe a little too carried away, causing too many offsides. Looks like it was an icing instead, we apologize. Taken around the bench is the Ice Lions. Pass to Mayer, goes around the boards. He passes it back behind the net. Taken by Green into the neutral zone where it gets stopped and dumped into the Ryder territory. Goalie saves it for his teammate. Good forechecking by Connolly as he swipes it from him. Good stick handling as well. Working his way around, still has it up to the blue line. Holding it around the blue line, centering shot, but no good as it goes off the goalie's pad. Behind the net, scrambling for it, against the boards, picked up by number 25 to Bornazian. Sent back down to Duncan. Duncan able to slowly get that one. Shot by Blacker. Or shot by Connolly. Connolly against the boards once again. Still scrambling for it. No one's able to get the hands on it as Connolly gets taken down by a Ryder player. Green, awesome forecheck and physicality, pushes him against the boards. Puck is still against the boards. And Ryder is finally able to clear it.
Hard hits by the Ryder defense, keeping the ice lines out of their zone. Great job shot blocking too.
Great shot. Behind the boards, ice lines bring it back in. Bornazian gets taken away, and Ryder now goes into the neutral zone. Bad pass as it's tipped. Around the boards, Ferry's able to control that one and pass it off to a player. But Ryder, excellent forecheck, makes them forced to get it out. Good forecheck by Ryder. Ice line's really trying to figure out what to do here next. Dumped into the neutral zone. And we see Collins coming up with speed around the net. A pass, but it goes off a foot, but he recollects it. Sends it back down to Evelino. Evelino passes it to Blacker with a one-timer. Nothing there. Ryder picks it up into the blue line. Pass back out. And Connolly's able to just keep it in.
Great forecheck by the ice line.
Great forecheck indeed. We're going to see an offsides again. There's 4 minutes left, or 4 minutes into the first period. A lot of rough gameplay, but nothing to show for it. Shots are 3-1 in favor of the Lions. Around the net is Drexel. And Drexel making a way out of their zone. Passing to the neutral zone, up Speedy. Ryder. Oh, Ryder, I'm sorry, I'm still used to yesterday's game. Let's see a stoppage of play here.
Even strength right now on both teams. Ice line's applying a little bit more pressure, taking the face off in their own zone.
I think they're just trying to fill each other out at this point. Who's going to make the first move? Who's going to show their cards first? Schumann with the defense, and they're finally able to get it out into the neutral zone where Agan is. Chasing it back now is Ashford. Sending it over to Schumann, back to Ashford, and around the boards. Missed pass. Agan passes it forward. And it's going to be an icing here as Drexel touches up.
Just misses that cross ice path to Schumann. That would be an icing face off in the ice line zone.
Face off won by Ice Lions as they get it out of the zone, forcing it into neutral territory. Ryder now has to figure out how to make their plan work here. Good defensive play by the Lions. Schumann takes that hit like a pro. Long into neutral zone, attacked by two guys, but still stays strong. Press in is long, long chases it behind the net, trying to get it away from Ryder, but Ryder just keeps up. Big hit by Long. Bad pass to De Laurentiis, but he's able to keep it. Pushing forward, big hits again. We're now getting physical like yesterday. Into the blue line, Connolly knocked down, and Ryder's not able to get that out. Connolly sends it to Owens. Owens with a shot. It goes off the post, not the sound you want to hear. And Ryder clears it.
He had that top left corner open. He just misses over the blocker, hits the post.
Good offensive play by the ice lines for sure. Around the boards, Ryder tries to get it out, and they succeed. Ice lines, Bornazian is going to have to set up. Or not, it's an icing.
Ryder has a lot of tired skaters on the ice right now, and that icing will not help. Face off in their own zone. Ice lines applying good pressure right now.
Very good pressure. We are going to see a face off to the left of Ryder's goalie. And Connolly will take this one. One by the ice lines, Connolly scrambling to get it, but Ryder is able to just kick it out. Ryder controlling it in their own zone. Duncan with an excellent forecheck, but Ryder's able to scoot by him. Into the offensive zone for Ryder. Ice lines holding their defense. A lot of missed passes here. Ryder's not able to fully collect it. Ryder picks it up. Backhand sliding shot, really too low, and Ferry's able to save that one. Mayer looking for a pass, and he puts it into the neutral zone. Chasing it down. We have Duncan around the net. Sends it back to the blue line. A one-timer shot, but it's too low, and an easy save by Ryder's goalie. Passing it out. Connolly to Green. Back to Mayer, or Johnson. Duncan back to Johnson again. Johnson's able to keep it in. Tipped by Mayer. Control on the board still by Mayer as he dumps it down around the boards. Duncan picked up. Big pressure by Ryder. Connolly scrambling to get that behind the net, but Ryder's able to take that, and they're going to counter strike into the neutral zone, and they dump it in instead for a line change.
Good pressure. Did not get any shots off, though, for the ice lines.
Not at all. Adam Johnson behind the net, trying to evade a Ryder player that's on his tail. Wide pass, and Collins isn't able to get it. Goes down around the boards. And the lines have to reset, trying to just get it out of the zone. Ryder collects it. Still scrambling. Collins picks it up. And now they're making their play and their counter-strike. In neutral zone, but is not very far before it's turned back around. Shot, but saved by Ferry. Into the neutral zone. Ryder can't seem to get the puck on. Good defense by Ice Lions. Very minimal time that they're able to keep it into their defensive zone. That's all they need. Less shots, less opportunities. Picked up by Leone. Leone looking for a move. And it goes trickling into the defensive zone of Ryder. Nelson with the forecheck, but Ryder's able to scoot by. Good move there by Ryder. Puck gets lost, almost taken away by Ice Lines, but they're able to regather it. And Ryder sends it back down. No icing here. Leone behind the net. Along the boards where it's stopped, but they're able to clear it. On the blue line, Ryder gets in. Ice Lines now hit into the neutral zone. Seems to be just like a game of pass again. But here we go, Ice Lines on a break. A little tripping call here on number 23. Nick Ruggiero from Ryder.
Yeah, Ruggiero stuck his skate out a little too far, clipped him, and that's gonna be 2 minutes in the box for him. Ice Lines on a power play.
Yep, there's their chance to make do of their aggression and momentum right now. They're on fire. This is definitely what they needed.
Teams are still feeling each other out, it appears, but the sloppy passing seems to be fixing up a little bit. Let's see if the Ice Lines get some shots off.
They're putting on the A team right here. We're going to see a face-off won by Ice Lines, but Drexel's able to intercept it. They're scrambling for it. Kept in by the Ice Lions. Good save here by 23 Wade Ashford, but they're going to call that an offside. He was just a little too far behind the blue line.
I believe that was a hand pass that they just called.
Yeah, hand pass. I apologize. In the neutral zone, Ryder's doing a good job of keeping them at bay. Speeding in is Connolly. And now we see, this time, an offside.
They just can't seem to get in the zone cleanly, which is not allowing them to get any pressure on yet. Ryder playing good defense.
Face-off won by Ice Lions as they're able to gather it in their zone, looking for a way to start up this power play once again. Not able to enter, and it's sent back down into their defensive zone. Working their way through Ice Lions territory, trying to find a way to get out. Pass into the neutral zone. Here comes Long. Long with speed. Behind the back. He goes wiped out. Big push. No penalty here. And that goes into the bench of Ryder, and we'll see a stoppage of play here.
Have about 1:08 left on the power play for the Ice Lions. Still zero shots. Almost at the midway point of this first period.
And we'll see Dayton Collins, the senior, take a draw. Drexel wins that one and sends it flying into there in the Ice Lions territory. Chasing it, keeping up the pressure is Ryder. All right, into neutral zone. Here comes the Ice Lions. Good move there by Leone, but that is going to be an offside as another player entered first. Seems to be having a lot of trouble with offsides today.
Have to be a little bit more patient entering that zone.
Face off again by Leone. And it's won by the Ice Lions. Knocked into the net, and we're seeing another face-off here at the blue line. About halfway through the first period, and no goals to show for it. Same thing with the penalty or the power play. It's only halfway through. Another stoppage of play. We'll see a face-off once again. A lot of back-to-back, not very long shifts here. They'll be on the left side of Ferry. Face-off won by Ice Lions. Bornazian picks it up. Nice pass over to number 19, De Laurentiis. Here comes Long again with speed. Aggression, a shot, but it goes nowhere around the net. De Laurentiis back to Green. Green passes it over to De Laurentiis. De Laurentiis shoots, but it goes off the goalie. And Ryder picks it up and sends it back down. 10 seconds left in the power play. Let's see if they can make at least one more move. It goes into the offensive zone, and then it will be an icing.
They finally were able to apply some pressure and get a shot off, but it was an easy save as he cut down the angle.
Yeah, not much you can do at that angle. Really hard to score on that one.
About 4 seconds left in the power play. Ryder looks like they survived.
Face-off win by Ice Lines, taken around the net. Green passes it out to the neutral zone. Ice Lines not able to push that same momentum, but they're still able to get inside the zone. Ryder picks it up. Almost got it out of the zone, but picked up by another Ryder player, which is another easy forecheck for Long. Long goes down through a check. Green with a shot, and it's off a player. Another shot deflected through traffic and couldn't seem to get to the net. Bornazian pass to De Laurentiis into the center of Long, and it goes wide. Working his way around the boards. Sent back, Bornazian. One timer from Green, but it goes wide once again off a deflection. De Laurentiis tries to pass it out. A shot by Bornazian. Rebound picked up by Connolly. Connolly to Green, Green to Bornazian. Bornazian with a shot. And it's still in through traffic, not able to contact with the goal or goalie. Big hit there by Connolly, but that's going to be a penalty here. And it seems that that is going to be elbowing.
He looked like he had his elbows tucked, but the ref saw it differently. Ryder going on a 2-minute power play.
Just to recap, it was number 26, Alec Connolly, 2 minutes. It is now Ryder's turn for the offensive hand on the power play. Ryder controls it on the blue line. Ryder with a shot, goes off the post, and an instant goal by number 43, Yeti Coyne.
That's just what you got to do on these power plays. You have to get the puck to the net, and you might get a lucky bounce. And it looks like Eddie Klein did, getting the first goal of the game.
And when I say they didn't waste a single moment on that power play, I mean it. It was literally an instant goal. Ferry didn't even see it coming.
Looked like Connolly was in and out of that box.
Well, with that power play aside and finished, it is now 1-0 in favor of Ryder. Drexel in their own zone, working their way in the neutral zone. Into Ice Lines territory. Good defense by Ice Lines, and they're able to get it out to the neutral zone.
Shots right now are 9-4 Ice Lines.
Duncan working his way through the forecheck, so along with Mayer. picked up by Iceline's neutral zone, sent to Duncan. Duncan enters. Duncan passes to Mayer. Mayer with a shot, and it goes wide. Mayer around the net. Pass to Duncan. Duncan back to Mayer. Not able to land contact with that. Onto the boards again. Big hit by Mayer. No penalty here. A shot all through the sticks, and it goes wide again by Connolly as he's out of the box very early. Johnson chasing it down.
Waves off the icing.
Big wave off icing. Sends it to neutral zone, and that is going to not be waved off, and it'll be icing based off the Lions. So we'll see a face-off in the Lions' territory.
7:15 left in this first period, and you would have thought the Ice Lions were outplaying them, outshooting them 10-4. But Ryder has that 1-0 lead, and that's really the only thing that matters.
Seems to notice that a lot with their games, is they come out strong with most shots, but they just gotta land them more. Face-off won by Drexel, or Ryder. I apologize once again. Ryder around the boards, but picked up by the Ice Lions. Mayer with speed, going down, but 43 was able to knock it out of his hands. Into the neutral zone, still battling for it. Ice Lines just make it in. Schumann with aggression. Schumann passes wide, and Avelino's not able to get that one. Ryder picks that one up, goes around the boards. Ice Lines with extreme forechecking, forcing them to make hasty moves, and they send it all the way back down to Ice Lines territory. That will also be an ice, or that will be covered up by Ferry. And we'll see a face-off here. I'm so used to all these back-to-back games with the same team, it's just flying off the tongue today.
Oh, yeah.
We'll see a face-off here. Off to the right of Ferry. Win by Dayton Collins, and Iceland take it around the net for a setting up to the shot. Schumann with the body, but Ryder's able to take it. Astrid clears it. And Ryder sends it back down. Picked up by Green. Around the boards. Waiting behind the net for an opportunity is Astrid. Ice Lines are now able to get into the neutral zone, making headway into Ryder territory. Oh, big shot by Avelino, but it's no good. Leone, extreme pressure here. Long tried to assist him, couldn't pick it up. Now Ryder's heading the other direction. Pass in the neutral zone, but Ryan Long was not able to keep his stick onto it. Stays in the neutral zone, and Ryder's gonna carefully handle this one. Line change for Ryder, getting some fresh feet on the ice while Bornazian takes it around his goalie's net. Into the neutral zone. Good moves here with the stick. Going around the net. A centering pass, but it tips off a few players. Owens tried to pass it to Long, but it goes wide. Meeting him is Bornazian, but he gets hit. Sends it back down to Long. And Ryder takes that one and gets it out. No penalty here as a Ryder player falls, and they're looking for a call, but they don't get it. Picked up, Ice Lines now in their territory, looking for a way to move. Pulling the goalie for an extra man as there is a delayed penalty. Ice Lines are trying to take advantage of this one. And we're gonna see a holding call. Not sure against who, as of right now. Get you that information very shortly. Looks like it's number 14.
That'd be DJ Sutcher on Ryder. Ice Lions going on their second power play. Last time they only were able to get one shot off. Let's see if they can put more pressure.
Into the neutral zone is Ice Lions. Connolly waits with it, taking his time, trying to make use of this power play. De Laurentiis into the neutral zone. Working his way, but he gets checked almost under the boards. Back to Ashford. A shot set up for Connolly, but it goes really low. Ashford looking for a pass. Holding it there. De Laurentiis back to Ashford. To Connolly. Connolly, back to De Laurentiis, to Connolly again. Keeping it around the blue line and the edges. Looking for a good opportunity to shoot. Cross the ice to Ashford. Wasn't expecting that. Wide pass. Connolly now picked that back up. Still able to keep it inside. Ow, Ashford just whiffed that one. Long tries to pick it up. And ice lines gain control once again. De Laurentiis to Long. Into the center, but it goes wide. Green struggling to get it. And Ryder's able to just hit it, but it's still kept in by Ashford.
Very impressive by the ice lines.
Very impressive. De Laurentiis passes it. Ashford with a one-timing shot, but it's low and it's off the goalie and a stick. Connolly still able to keep with it to the blue line. Still kept in by Ashford. Oh, now goes to the neutral zone. Ryder's going to try to make attempt of this. Ryder can't scoot by too much with the stick there, and it goes a little off. And Long picks that up.
Great one-on-one defense. They were cycling around, applying great pressure with the cross-ice passes, just whiffing on the shots. Great saves by the goalie of Ryder.
Indeed. Less than 3 minutes left in the first period. Our score is still 1-0 Bronx. Still trying to find a way to get out of the side. Adam Johnson passes into the neutral zone.
Power play over.
Leone working his way through, but gets hit by two guys. Evelino going to meet him, but couldn't get the puck. And Ryder is just able to finally get it out. A little toss up here with Mayer and number 27, Nicholas Padula. Mayer's looking for a penalty call, but he's not getting anything. And it's covered up by Ferry.
Shots are 14-6 right now with 2:13 left in the first period in favor of the Ice Lions.
We'll see a face-off here off to the left side of Ferry.
It looks like they got Mayer with a 2-minute penalty.
So we'll see another power play for Ryder, see if they can make more advantage of this. Dayton Collins on the shorthanded attempt. It's a breakaway. He goes through. Collins shoots, but it goes low, and it's off the pad. An easy save. Collins picks it up and tries to make use of this. And it goes back down.
That would have been a huge momentum swing if he was able to score on the shorthand.
Great way to waste the clock. And here comes Ryder. Going in deep. Around the net. But Ice Lines pick that up, and they're able to get it out. Here we go. Connolly moving forward. Another shot, and it goes off the pad really easily. Big hit. Number 10 did not like how he treated the goalie. Kept inside. Really short-handed goal, and it's deflected. Looks like it was Bornazian.
Oh, it was a great setup right there off the two breakaways they had short-handed. Gets the rebounds after the kick save. Crosses it back to the middle. Keeps applying pressure and tips it in for a goal for the Ice Lions. Ties it up before the first period ends.
An unexpected short-handed goal, and that is true, Kyle. We are now tied. Just goes to show that anything can happen in hockey.
A minute 18 left on the Ryder power play.
Let's see if they can still make use of it, or if the Ice Lions will keep their momentum and aggression. Sent in, really hard smack against the boards. Ice Lions are showing ferocity. Ryder into the neutral zone, carefully making a play that don't want to lose the puck like they did last time. Around the boards, and they're still able to keep it. Ice Lions with great defense, making sure that the puck is away from their stick at all times. Bornazian against the boards. Still kept playing it around the circle here. Closing in the gap to 12, a shot, and it's wide. Ice Lines playing very carefully, not trying to get too carried away, and it's a goal.
It looked like the goalie was not ready for that shot. Came out of nowhere with real quick from Ryder, and just like that, they take the lead back with 44 seconds left.
Goal scored. Yeah, goal was scored by number 14, DJ Suker. And just like that, it is a one-gap game in favor of Ryder. Sort of like last night, Ice Lions just can't seem to get ahead, but they are sticking with them, and there's still two periods left to play. just about 30 seconds wind down in this first period, and Ryder holds it into the neutral zone, picked up by Ice Lions, dumped in, and is held there by the Ryder goalie. Good defense by Ice Lions, good forechecking, and Ice Lions caress it at neutral ice. Inside, we see Nelson with a shot. It gets whiffed and deflected. Picked up by Strobel. A shot here goes wide. Hagen wasn't able to seem to get a handle on that one. Around the boards. And Ryder wasn't quite able to get it out, but a shot, a last-minute attempt. Easy blocker save, and that concludes the first period. How did you think they did so far, Kyle?
Ice Lions applying great pressure so far. 18 shots in the first period, and especially towards the end, they were out skating them.
Oh, yes.
I mean, it was not close what their effort was, but they just fall up short towards the end. It's 2-1 going into the second period.
It's a close game, but there's still a lot of time left. And we'll see you back here for second period real soon. They're not able to get back. They're not able to get that out. Connolly sends it to Owens. Owens with a shot. Chasing it down. We have Duncan around the net. A face-off won by Ice Lines. Good move there by Leone. Rebound picked up by Connolly. Connolly to Green. Green to Bornazian. Bornazian with a shot. Up by Ice Lines in the neutral zone. Sent to Duncan. Duncan enters. Duncan passes it to Mayer. Mayer with a shot. De Laurentiis passes it. Asher with a one-timing shot. Kept inside. Really short-handed goal, and it's deflected. Looks like it was Bornazian.
That was a great set.
Ice Lions fans, welcome back to the second period. It is... About yourself.
I'm Katie Knoll. I'm a sophomore. I'm majoring in digital print journalism and political science. And I got into hockey because I grew up in Hershey, Pennsylvania. We have an AHL team there, the Hershey Bears, and I've been going to them pretty much my entire life. So awesome. Happy to be here.
Yeah, we're happy to have you. We're looking forward to carrying this out throughout the rest of the season. So you were watching most of the game in the first period. So tell me, what do you think the Ice Lions are really struggling upon and what they could improve?
Issue right now is not being able to finish. They have great shots, but their shots are coming from some pretty strange angles that are pretty easy for the goalie to get pads on. So I think they need to get some higher quality shots, but keep that offense going.
Excellent analysis. I
Thank
agree.
You.
Maybe a little bit more connecting passes and also not taking that many penalties. I feel like they've taken a little too many, even though they did score their goal on a shorthanded goal.
Yeah.
Maybe just dial back some of the penalties, play aggressive, but we got to watch those sticks and those shoves.
Yeah.
All right.
We have the speed there.
Yes. Back at it, we have Connolly taking the faceoff here, and it'll be won by Ryder. Ryder carrying it in their defensive zone, sends it back out into the neutral zone, intercepted by Ice Lines. Moving their way in is Mayer to Duncan, a shot, and it goes wide. Around the net, Ice Lines are trying to break out, and they do so. Connolly holds onto it, passes it to Duncan, but it goes a little wide around the boards. Picked up by Mayer. Mayer sends it across to Connolly, but it goes a little too far back. Connolly's just able to keep it in before Ryder takes possession. Centering pass, but it goes past through Duncan. And it gets out of the zone. Schumann recollecting in, passes it forward for another charge. Mayer to Duncan. Duncan across, but it's a bad pass. And it goes around the boards. Ryder picks that up, sends it down, and we're going to see an icing here.
Yeah, there's also a lot of icing and offsides in the first period, so they could definitely clean that up a little bit.
Yeah, you might only want to do icings when you're getting a little too overwhelmed, but not all the time. It's just not smart.
Yeah, it kills that momentum that they've
Does.
They have going.
Unless, of course, you're the team that doesn't have the momentum.
Yeah.
Face-off here on the left side of Ryder. Ryan Long shoves that down, and Matt Owens goes to take it. Passed out, here comes Ryder, making up with speed into the neutral zone, working their way around a shot. Nothing here. Ryder still figuring out what to do as they're being bombarded by players. Good defense by Ice Lines. Around the net, here's Bornazian. Bornazian setting up shot, looking for a move. He finds his opportunity, sends it to Green, but he gets stopped. Into the neutral zone. Ryder, now in the neutral zone with it, sends it back out. But after a few hits off the skate, Ice Lines pick it up and go the other way. Same thing happens, and Ryder now has it. Ryder, a shot off the pads of Ferry. Bornazian looking for a pass, and he breaks it out. Nice clear. Ryder now coming in, picking it up, shot. And a save by Ferry. going into the neutral zone, really trying to force that out, but Ryder's doing well, is able to keep it in their possession at least. So Ryan Long now has it in the offensive zone. Low shot, the stick is thrown, and there is no opportunity made here. A shot by Leone, but it's still covered up by Ryder's goalie, and we'll see a stoppage of play here.
Both teams are getting a lot of rebound opportunities, but they're not really capitalizing on them, so that's another area that they could improve right now going forward.
Yes, and Ryder's goalie, Guerreros, he is just on top of it. He just seems to be making those breakaway saves. It's really impressive. Faceoff won by Dayton Collins. As ice lines hold it around the sides. Around the boards they throw it, and it's kept at the blue line. Sent down to Evelino. Crossing the centering slot, and it goes a little wide. Ice line still able to keep it in. They shoot it down. Ryder picks it up. And it goes into the neutral zone. A clear for Ryder. Sent back in. Here we go on another rush for the ice lines. Ryder doing an excellent job on defense, really cutting off their angles for the shots. And we'll see an icing here. Face off here by Collins, off to the right of Ryder's goalie, and it's won by Ryder. Ryder working its way in the neutral zone, really getting tied up there. Blacker sends that to Johnson, and it goes to the neutral zone once again. Now Johnson's able to set up here. Johnson over to Collins. Collins making his way through the neutral zone into enemy territory. He gets hit and nailed, and he goes down. That was a clean hit. Neutral zone, here comes Ryder. Ryder with three men, a shot, and it's saved by Ferry with the pads. Avellino chasing it back out of the neutral zone. He's gonna make his way forward. Big rush here, scoots his way around, able to keep control, a shot, but it goes a little too high. Up against the boards, ice lines are trying to maintain that possession, but Ryder's really forcing them to make a move soon. Ryder collects it, and now they're gonna deal with it in their own zone. Kept in by Ice Lions, only momentarily, and it's now off.
With how many chances Ice Lions have had, Ryder's definitely doing a great job shutting them down.
I do agree. They are really putting their bodies in front of them. They are not letting them touch their goalie, and that's what you have on a good defensive line. Mm-hmm. Seems like is deflected out of play. So we're gonna have a face-off here in Ice Lions territory. Give her a roast. Face-off win by Ryder, and they're gonna keep it along the blue line. Storming around, a shot, and it is no good there. Ryder sends it back down behind the boards. Big hit by Nate Schumann, the alternate captain. And they're able to break out. They send it back down. Collected by Givorowski. And Ryder's gonna make another attempt here. They get in. Good stick work there, but not good enough as Long is able to take that one and go straight down to the opposite end. Wasn't able to keep his stick on, and he is pushed against the boards. Ryder now recollects from their mistake, and they're on for another push. Line change here for some fresh guys on the ice. Ryder sends it down across the ice, around the back, picked up. And good defense by Green. Got his stick in the way. Bornazian sends it back down, but intercepted. Still kept by Ryder, and now Leone's able to finally clear it. Givorowski holds it. Sends it into the neutral zone, but it comes right back, and Ryder will have a chance to recollect. Making their way on the play. Good forechecking by the ice lines, and it's kept inside the zone for longer. Collins skating with him. Ryder makes it across, a shot, but nothing there. Sends it back to the blue line. Alternate captain on Ryder holds it, sends it back. a shop and it goes off a skate. Another shop, Easy Save by Ferry, and it is out of the territory and they will have to chase it.
Looks like it might be icing. Nope,
they're just able to get to it. Johnston, able to pick it up and send it back. Ryder still able to keep it in. Good work there. A shot and an easy snatch out of the air by Ferry. A little bit of sportsmanship right here between the two teams. Love to see it. And we'll have a face-off off to the left of Ferry. The puck is dropped and the Lions win that one as well. Around the net is Blacker. He sends it back for Johnston. Johnston holds on to it. He sends it forward to the neutral zone. Skating down. Still in the neutral zone, it comes back down and they have to regather. Ice Lions worked his way around and sends it into the neutral zone once again. Picked up by Ryder. Not much progress being made by either team. Ryder throws it down in. A low pass to nowhere, but Ryder keeps at the blue line. Another shot, but it's saved by Ferry in the deflected stick. Around the net is the captain, 22, for Ryder, passing it to the blue line. A shot that's low and an easy save by Ferry. Another rebounded shot, it goes wide. Blacker picks that one up, and he sends it to neutral ice with a long toss. Johnston picks up along the boards and sends it back down. A little hit given to him, but he doesn't care. Neutral zone, now inside of ice line territory, picked up by Johnston. Passed in by De Laurentiis. He goes forward looking for an opportunity here, and he wipes out. Saved by Givorowski.
Something that I've noticed for the Ryder shots is that they seem really low and they seem easy, but there are also sticks that are getting in the way.
A lot of sticks getting in the way. A lot of deflected hits.
So it could end up being some challenging saves for our goalie.
It's a really good chance, but you know, we gotta have a little bit more variety. Right now they have a comfortable lead of 2-1, so it doesn't matter too much. Off to the blue line, and they go chasing down. It's a race. A big foot race, but Ice Lions were able to get that one strategically, sent into neutral ice. Leone in across the blue line. Still working way around the boards, and Ryder's able to get that. Into the neutral ice, now making headway. Trying to work around him, but Collins is able to pick that up. Or Ashford is able to pick that one up. Into neutral ice, Ryder's trying to make a play, and it goes back down in. Good forechecking by Ryder as he goes into the boards. Another hit there. Leone's keeping up with him, making sure that they don't have enough time to work with the puck. Up against the boards, really big collisions here. Holding it there, trying to delay time. And the ref got a little anxious there, so we'll see a face-off. Unfortunately, we don't have any updates on Dalia. He was able to get himself off the ice, but we're still trying to get that information. We really do hope he's okay and well. Face off here. Drexel's able to, or Ryder's able to get that one. And here comes Duncan in a neutral zone. Around the board is tied up sticks. Ryder's able to keep it. Around the boards, making a play. Ooh, good defense there by Duncan. Ryder now into neutral ice. Big hit there, but he is unfazed. Green picks that one up, and now they're gonna make a counter strike. Here comes Bornazian. Bornazian passes into center ice. Dumps it in, is Mayer. Around the boards, picked up by Connolly. Connolly between two guys right now, holding it against the boards. Not making any headway here. And they finally clear it out. Picked up by Bornazian, still struggling to keep it in, but he's able to kick it out. He goes down, that's a delayed penalty. And it's gonna be a tripping call. And I believe that will be against the Ice Lions.
This penalty kill is going to be a little bit better than the last Ice Lions penalty kill.
You said it. And it will will be number 10, Justin Bornese, will be in the box for tripping. They scored on a shorthanded goal before. Let's see if they can do it again. Johnson hits it out, but it's gathered by the blue line. Low shot, and it goes wide. Blacker gets a stick on it. Ryder still keeps it, sends it out around the blue line, keeping up at top, a slapper, and he covers up. And Ferry with a good save, stopping momentum.
Ice Lions right now really just need to focus on staying together as a team, preventing a goal against, and then hoping that they can get all players back for a good offensive push.
Faceoff won by Ice Lions, but they're not able to get it out of the zone. Good positioning by Long. They send it across and it is missed. De Laurentiis slaps it trying to get it out, but it's picked up by Ryder. Ryder sends it to the blue line. A whiffed shot, or a whiffed pass, and Long keeps up at the point. Ryder with a shot and it's low again. Ryder around the blue line, number 14, passing it down. Keeping it around the circle, closing the gap. A little bouncy, but it's still saved by Ferry, and he covers it up.
A lot of pushing in front of the goal going on, trying to make space.
Yeah. There's one thing you don't want to do is piss off the other team's goalie or mess with the other team's goalie. You don't want their teammates coming in front of you. Pick a fight where you don't need it. Ryder. Ryder at the blue line. Ryder still keeping around, closing the gap, and it's a bounce, but it's off wide. Ryder holds it there. Ryder off. Intercepted by Connolly, and he's going to take his move. He's going to go forward, pass it to Schumann. Schumann gets across. And couldn't see what was going on there. We'll see a face-off off to the left or the right of Ryder. Ryder's goalie, Givorowski. Face-off win by Collins, and they're kept in the neutral zone. 30 seconds left in the power play. But Ice Lions are doing a good job right now keeping it out of Ryder's possession. A shot down low. A cleared shot, dumped in, but Ryder's able to take that. And now they make their way to the neutral zone. Looking for a push here to finish off this power play. And they're able to collect it. A shot, but it goes off of Ashford. Here comes Collins. Passing it up to Leone, up to Schumann, making headway here. A shot put off the pad of Ryder or Givorowski, and it's no good. Avellino wipes out, not able to make a play in the neutral zone. And Ashford able to dump it in the neutral zone and get it out of their territory.
Ice Lions seem to be picking up some speed, so hopefully they can do something with it.
Ryder gets across, it's not offsides. And Avellino tries tapping it up. Now they call that offsides. And we'll see a face-off closer to Ryder's goalie.
Through the period, no change in the score so far.
Scoreless period, that is for sure, yes. Connolly in the blue line, Ice Lions working their way around, carrying that momentum that they had. A shot, and it goes a little off a player, and that goes into the mesh.
Ryder seems seems to be picking up on more shots. Now it's 25 to 19 shots.
De Laurentiis keeps it to the blue line pass. Back to De Laurentiis. Centering pass, but off a Ryder player skate. Sent back down in. And Iceland still maintain possession to De Laurentiis. And down, back down low. Centering pass, but to nobody. And it is cleared. There was a penalty for Ryder on the other hand, so Iceland do have the man advantage. It was on number 12, TJ Evan. Connolly, working his way in the defensive zone, gets sticked away by a Ryder player, forcing him to wait even longer to make advantage of this power play. Still not able to get out. Excellent forechecking by Ryder. Sent into the neutral zone is Long. Long is making his way through. A little dangle there, but not able to have an opening. Sends back to the blue line, but it goes out, and they're going to have to reset. Entering in again, getting wiped out around the edges. There's Mayer. Mayer with a move and a shot, and Mayer scores. Brendan Mayer, now it's 2-2. Definitely made advantage on this power play.
So at this point in the game, they have a shorthanded goal and a power play goal. Still.
Seems like they can only score if they're at a disadvantage or the enemy is.
Yeah, all of the goals so far have been on a power play, one way or the other.
Indeed it has. Maybe they just need to get more power plays. 26, Conley takes that draw, but Ryder takes the win on that one. A shot and a save by Farrah. Mayer again with speed, maybe looking for a second one. Gets tied up on the boards and it goes loose. Iceland still able to keep it in, sends it through, and saved by Givorowski. Just about a little over 6 minutes left in this second period. Both teams played really hard, and Iceland are the only ones to score in this period so far. Face-off one kept in the zone by Iceland. Centering pass, but goes up to the blue line, and it goes wide. Chased back down by Blacker, and Blacker's going to take it around the net to reset. Finally making their way to the neutral ice, but Ryder picks it up and now turns it back over. Ice Lions pushing forward, carefully though. Losing his footing there is Mayer. And it's kept around the boards. Duncan's going in for it. Teamed up by two Ryder players, not able to get it off the boards. A scram, Connolly. And Ryder's able to break that play up. A shot by Duncan and it goes wide. Still working their way around the boards. No one's able to get a full hand on it. And Ryder is now able to make a counter strike. Here they come in and it gets offside and they're gonna have to reset as well. Ice Lions have a chance to make a play here. Dumped in and picked up by De Laurentiis. Pass back to nobody and Ryder takes that one away. A collision by Ryder. Both players hit each other and now they have to reset again as that big disruption by their own team.
One's coming off the ice, seems to be in some pain.
Yeah. Can't be worse than getting hit by your own teammate. Ryder's gonna carefully play it in their defensive zone. They dump it in. It's going all the way down and icing will be called here. Are 26-19 in favor of the Ice Lions. Pretty high score, or high shot range for second period. Face off won by Ryder. But Ice Lions are doing great with the forecheck. Bad pass by Ryder and it gets tipped to an Ice Lions player. Now they're going back in on the attack, but it is going to be covered up by Givorowski. Thank you. Tony taking this draw. And Ryder wins that and clears it out of the zone.
In the neutral zone. Anyone's puck here, it gets taken in by the ice lines.
Dumped in by Schumann and picked up by Leone against the boards. A shot by Collins, and it goes wide, high into the mesh. Face off one here, tie up, but ice lines are able to get that one. Around the net. Big collision here, but ice lines are not able to keep up with the pace. Ice lines are shot, and Ryder picks up again. Big hit behind the net, and De Laurentiis goes down. Moving up is Ryder. Bornazian's able to chip that puck away just for a moment to stop his play. As Ryder sets up, it goes into the neutral zone, and they have to chase again. Ryder dumps it in the neutral zone, and they're going to make another rush. Carefully planning it out, but they dump it in. Looking for a line change, and Ryder gets it. Sticked off. Mayer sends it back down to Johnson, who's going to handle this one. Sent in the neutral zone. Connolly finally hits it out, and it goes into the offensive territory. Connolly rushes forward again, but it gets knocked back into ice line's defensive zone. Making headway, here comes Connolly. Connolly trying to scoot by, but two players got the best of him. Around the boards. Up on the blue line, a shot, but deflected through a few players.
A lot of back and forth right now.
A lot of back and forth indeed.
Here comes Ryder.
Ryder takes a shot and an easy save by Ferry. We'll see a faceoff off to his left in just a moment. So Katie, how would you say the physicality has been faring in this period? Is it more than last, or is it getting less?
I think there are a few times where players might get frustrated, get a little bit pushy, but overall I think it's a little bit less than last period. Yeah, at least no injuries, major injuries at least.
Yes, I think they're trying to play it safe. Another stoppage of play here, and we'll see a face-off in the same spot.
Face-off win by Ice Lines, but they aren't able to get it out of the zone quite yet. Schumann passes it over to Nelson in a neutral zone, but they're not able to get it. Ryder now with a speedy strike, a whiffed shot, and another shot, and it goes low.
Around the boards, Ryder's going to be able to somewhat keep this in. Nelson working for it. Ashford keeping up, gets the puck. Not quite able to dump it out, Ryder's still able to keep it in. Agan, not able to do some work, but it gets sent back to Ashford so they can finally have a chance to collect themselves. Shot into center, and here comes Strobel.
Strobel going straight down, working his way through.
Around the edges, he takes a centering pass shot, and it goes nowhere. Ryder collects that, and they're going to make the offensive counter strike. Dumping it in.
Big hit, center ice.
On the bench.
Looks like the Ryder bench has complained to the ref about an elbowing.
There was a pretty big hit at center ice that left the Ryder player down. Got up on his own, though, so that's a good thing.
Doesn't seem like the ref is budging, but the coach is surely mad about that.
He'll definitely feel that one in the morning.
I think he already feels it.
It will be a power play, and it is going to be elbowing. Penn State number 6, Nate Schumann, will be going to the box. 2 minutes for elbowing.
So this 2 minute penalty is gonna start the third period as well, since there's some overlap.
Yep, 1 minute, less than 1 minute and 30 seconds left. So yes, Ryder will have a chance to expand on that in the third period. Let's see what Ryder can do to make use of this power play and how the ice lines will respond. Ryder takes it, keeps it in the zone. Looking for a move, a shot goes off a few bodies and it bounces. Ferry did not see that one coming. Hornazian being really physical here, and Leone's able to knock that one out. Ryder will have to reset in their own zone. Working their way into neutral ice.
Down to 1 minute left in the second.
Yep. Goes a little bit wide, but Ryder's still able to keep it. A little shove here by Mordazian doesn't seem to faze the ref or the player. And Green sends that back out, forcing to chase it. There's Leone trying to meet with him. Gets in front of the goalie, tries to take it away, really playing aggressive against him, being brave. Collins able to help him out here. Collin wipes out along the boards. But they're keeping
the
it. What?
Little poking with the stick.
Little poking with the stick. Good play by Collins by keeping it inside the zone for a little while, killing that penalty. Hornazian meeting up with him against the boards. Ryder keeps on the blue line. Holding him there. Ryder's not able to make a move quite yet. On the blue line, a shot, and it goes off the pad of Ferry. And that is the end of the second period. Only one goal scored this period, and that was by the ice lines, tying the game 2-2. Like Katie mentioned earlier, 34 seconds will be carried over into the third period, and we will see you very soon for that, see the outcome. Ryan Long now has it in the offensive zone. No shot. Ryder with three men. A shot, and it's saved by Ferry with the pads. Big rush here. Scoots his way around. Able to keep control. Passing it up to Leone. Up to Schumann. Making headway here. A shot, but off the pad of Ryder. Again. Getting wiped out around the edges. There's Mayer. Mayer with a move and a shot, and Mayer scores. Brendan Mayer. Now it's 2-2. Welcome back to the third period of Ryder versus Ice Lions. I got it right this time. So far in the second period, there was only one goal scored, and that was by the Ice Lions, but a lot of penalties were made. Even one is going into the third period, Brendan Mayer for elbowing. But on the other hand, we have Ryder with their goalie, Givorowski, who's just doing an excellent job. Kyle, what do you have to say about him?
Oh, Givorowski has been outstanding this game. He's really been keeping Ryder in the game still. It is a 2-2 game going into the third period. He's been great. The Ice Lions have a great job screening him all game, but he's still seeing through the screen, stopping all the pucks. He did let one go in that second period, but overall has been outstanding.
Couldn't agree with you more. He's going to be a really tough wall to face for the Ice Lions. What do you think the Ice Lions need to do to prepare for this period? What do you think is their biggest issue right now?
I think they need to, they're handling adversity great as they were going down two times in this game and tying the game up. Just like last night, how they couldn't finish the game until the shootouts, I think they need to avoid that and just keep applying pressure and getting shots in.
Yeah, like we mentioned earlier, both games between yesterday and today, the Ice Lions have not been able to lead until the very end. So let's see if they can maybe change that, pull away, and let's hope that they can possibly get another win at home and stay undefeated here. Ryan Long at the center ice, gonna take this face off here. Drop, and Ryder will take that one. Long wipes out at center ice, but he gets back up like it's nothing. Long throwing the body, getting the puck away from Ryder, but they're able to take it and push it in through the neutral zone. Dumped back down in. Not offsides, and no icing. Ryder is going to make a play here and in the neutral zone. Off a body, and Ice Lions were able to pick it up just for a moment. Now Ryder finally enters the zone, shoots it, goes around the goal, and picked up by Long. Long, trying to be aggressive, dumps it in. Long keeping up the pressure, but Ryder's able to collect it pretty easily. Into the neutral zone, Schumann dumps it right back in. Finally, and now the power play is over for Ryder. Collins with the forecheck, but Ryder's able to get it to neutral ice, and here they go for a rush. A shot, and that one goes wide. Collins now takes it for his rush in the neutral zone, looking for a pass, but is guarded by a man and can't seem to get by. Good forecheck by Leone, knocking it behind the net. And Ryder's able to collect this one. Not quite, as Leone's able to scoop it up. Kept in the Ice Lions offensive zone, sent back down for Avellino to get. No one's able to fully keep their control over the puck as they both scramble for it. Sent around to the blue line and picked up by Johnson. Sent back down, but it goes around the goal. And we see a cover up by Givorowski.
Ice Lions still looking for their first shots of the third period. Ryder looks like they came out a little bit stronger. Ice Lions will get a faceoff in the Ryder zone looking to apply more pressure.
Face-off off to the right side of Givorowski, and Connolly is not able to win that one. Ryder dumps it out, but is caught, and is kept in with the blue line. Mayer putting up the pressure, and it gets sent back down regardless. Ice Lions now have it in their defensive zone, looking to make a move. Stays in the neutral zone, and then gets sent back down for Ferry to collect. Blacker stumbles and reefs someone into the boards. Ice Lions are finally able to clear that. Mayer with a sliding hit. Now the aggression has picked up.
Very physical game.
And Ryan Givoreski is able to shoot that around the boards, but it's still kept in. Ice Lions are not letting this one get out. Sent back and picked up by Blacker, sent down. And finally, Ryder makes contact and sends it into the neutral zone. Ryder now still collects it. Struggles with passes here, really bad pass, misinterpreted passes on both teams, as no one's able to fully hold possession of it. Ryder sends it to the neutral zone and it goes right back. Here comes Green. Green with a centering slot pass and it misses completely. Gets sent back down and picked up by Bornazian. Sent through to neutral ice. And now Long's racing, trying to get them off their toes.
Long has been outskating Ryder all game. He's been great applying pressure.
He's a very physical and aggressive player. I love his speed. Definitely worthy for being captain. Goes into the neutral zone and is making their rush against Givoreski, who picks it up and sends it around the boards. Nelson back to the blue line. Bornazian with a shot that's bouncy but doesn't go anywhere. Sent back down to Bornazian. Tries to make a move and he succeeds. Almost gets a little bit tripped up there. Really wide pass and forces Green to go chase down. And we're going to see a line change for both teams.
Givoreski has not been shy to come out of his net and use his stick to play the puck. Hopefully that does not bite him in the end.
Into the offensive zone and it's going to be an icing. Agin was not able to beat that in time. Shots are now closer to even, 29-25, still in favor of the Ice Lions. Score is still 2-2. And just about 4 minutes has passed in this last period. Win by Ryder. But it goes inside someone's pads and we're going to see a face-off here.
With all four goals coming through power plays in this game, you got to wonder if teams are going to try and be a little less aggressive towards each other and try and maintain all five skaters on the ice.
Time will tell for sure. Ryder wins that one. That was a shot that went wide around the net. Shot up again. Making headway, but not able to secure that. Evelino picks it back up and sends it back down to Leone. Leone tries to pass it back to the blue line. It gets a little loose there. The Lions are able to recollect it. Sent back into Ryder's zone, and they're going to have to reset and figure out what to do here. Looking for an opportunity, they wait with it behind the net. A nice pass, and they go into the neutral zone. And it gets sent right back down for Givoreski to handle. No one's able to close contact to that puck, but good forechecking by the Ice Lions. Almost a breakaway here, but they lost control of the puck, so Ryder couldn't take advantage of that. Ryder sends it back to their zone to regroup. With speed up the ice, he dumps it in. And it's going to be picked up by Ashford, struggling against the boards. Leone chips it over, and it goes a little wide. But they're not able to clear it as it stays inside the offensive zone for Ryder.
Most of this third period has been played through the neutral zone. Both teams looking to break that ice.
Ryder's holding it in their zone. Finally making their exit. A big hit from the back by Blacker by the blue line. Mayer gets that cleared out. And Ryder dumps it back in, or tries to, and that goes out of play.
But this time, we will look ahead for the next home games for this Ice Lions. In 2 weeks, February 4th and 5th, they will be playing at 7:30 and 4:30.
Yes, looking forward to seeing those games. Puck is dropped, and Ice Lions will take that one as it goes trickling back down in their zone. Excellent forecheck by Ryder. Not able to get their hands controlling on the puck, but Mayer's gonna bring that around the boards here, and it will be cleared. Ryder gathers it behind the net. Big forecheck by Duncan. and dumped back in over the goalie. And Gavrovsky isn't fazed by that one. Big pileup along the boards, a lot of aggression here. Icelines are trying to keep it in, trying to make a move around the boards, around the net, and a save by Gavrovsky within his pads as Mayer gets shoved down.
A lot of extra shoves by 27 by Ryder, Nicholas Padula. He looks like he is ready for his team to get a little bit more aggressive in this period.
And I'd say a pretty big guy here too, not someone you want to mess with right away. Mayer gets up and he is okay. Little side commentation, but they're kind of laughing at each other. Don't think it's really too bad here. And Long's going to take the face off on the right side of Gavrovsky.
Like Ryder will be on the power play.
Yes, it seems like Schumann has another, or not Schumann. It seems like Icelines are actually going to be on the power play on this one. Icelines keeping in the offensive zone, working their way around the blue line. Closing in the gap. No shot there, but they're able to keep it in. On the blue, whiffs that pass, and Ryder is able to try to disrupt it, but Icelines can recollect it. Here comes Long. Long passes back to Ashford, over to Connolly. Connolly back to Ashford. Ashford a shot, and it goes off the goalie's elbow. Connolly holds it down low, sends it over to Long. Good forecheck and defense there by Ryder. Sent over to Connolly, a one-timer shot, but it goes a little off to the left. Smacked into the glass, wasn't able to clear it. Another shot by Connolly, no good there as Gavrovsky stops it. And they send it back down and they're finally able to clear it.
Good pressure by the ice lines, really circulating the puck around, getting some good shots off.
Ice lines are now gonna regroup, figure out how to execute the rest of this power play. With just 37 seconds left. They make it in, but Ryder's able to send it right back down, and Schumann's gonna go chase it. Schumann looking for an opportunity here, sends it across his neutral zone. Dumped in. Leone chasing it. It's around the boards, scooped up in here by Mayer. Mayer looking for a move, going in deep, or close, a shot. And it's around the edge of the goal, and he just saves it. Gavrovsky puts his glove over it, and that's the end.
Great move in tight. Gavrovsky, for the first time tonight, looked rattled, but was able to keep it out of his net.
I'm not sure anyone knew where the puck was.
No. These two teams will meet again next week at Ryder. If it's anything like this game, it should be a great one.
Both are really good contending teams. Both play really well and they seem to be stumping each other. Face-off win by Ryder and they send it right back down. 3 seconds left and that is the end of the power play. We're at even strength once again. Sending it to Duncan. Duncan looking for his way in but gets stopped by Ryder. A big missed hit, but he loses his stick and now Mayer has nothing to use it or use the puck with. Sent down for a shot, but it goes off the skate of Duncan and a big hit there on the board. Schumann gets it a shot, goes wide, and Bornazian with a pass at the blue line sends back down. No one's able to quite get that one.
Good fight in front of Gavrovsky.
Into the neutral zone. Now back into Iceline's offense. See if they can execute something here. Connolly with a good stick move. Looking for a pass. A slapper, and there's no good. Great one-time shot by Mayer. Mayer getting physical here, trying to push people out of his lane. And Blacker collects it, sends it back into the zone. Ryder's able to dump it in and get a line change.
Iceline's looking to get a line change as well. Both the skaters were tired.
Around the net, they dump it in. And it goes sent back down for an icing. So we'll see a face-off here by Ferry.
Iceline seemed to have picked it up in the last couple minutes. building momentum off their first power play. Did not get a goal, but now they're getting some shots up. Have four in this period to the Ryder, two shots.
Mm-hmm.
Puck is dropped and Ryder wins that one. But just like that, Leone's able to tip, poke check that out of the zone. Carefully held by ice lines in their zone. Here comes Johnson, dumps that back down. Leone picks that up and enters the attacking zone. But Ryder's able to just get that out just as quickly. Johnson makes his way around the net, looking for a play. There we go, as Dayton Collins comes through with speed. Dayton Collins, the senior, up to the centering shot, and it's a good block by Givorowski.
Great pass and great save by Givorowski.
One of the best connected passes.
Givorowski looks like he could be hurt right now.
Yeah. Maybe it was the puck that hit him. Something got there, but he's down on the ground.
The puck might have snuck past a pad, or he might have outstretched a leg. It was a great save off of a great pass by the Ice Lions, but he's slow to get up.
Great save, but at what cost? Well, speaking of injuries, we got a little bit of an update on Dalia. He was able to get up on his own power, but he will not be returning this game.
We saw him walk off on his own accord, which is great to see, but it does not look like he was going to come back. Now we just hope Givorowski's okay.
Played an excellent game so far. I'd hate to see him leave the game so soon.
Yeah, he's been the reason why Ryder has been still in this game.
Yes.
I mean, he's faced 31 shots, has saved 29. And a lot of them have been very great contested shots. I mean,
there's one thing the Ice Lions can do is they can put multiple shots on the goalie. They just got to learn to sink them a bit more. But the more shots on goal you can get, the more chances you can score. It's just the same thing every chance. You can't very miss true. The net like those wide shots Ryder's been taking this last few few plays. Yeah, he really looks like he's struggling. He's able to get up though.
After he made that save, he looked like he was trying to stretch and fake that he was all right, and then the ref had to stop play. He still looks like he wants to stay in the net.
Yeah, he doesn't want to go down without a fight, that's for sure. Doing some maneuvers, trying to test it out, see if he can really play on it.
On the other side of the ice, it looks like the ref is talking to the ice lines, seeing if they're still playing fairly.
Both teams are just as worried, but what I like about these two teams is that they're able to get really down and physical during the game, but then once the whistle blows, it's a pat on the back. So I've seen a lot of those recently. It's a nice sportsmanship.
Ton of respect between both of these teams, as we saw last night as well. Two great games this weekend that we had on Friday and Saturday night. Both will be rematched away for the Ice Lions next week.
Yeah, that's very true. A great game is when it's close, and it's been close, especially these last two games.
Mm-hmm.
Well, just under 10 minutes left in this game once it resumes. Will we see another overtime? And if so, will it go into another shootout? Or will someone be able to land another goal and win?
It looks like Givorowski gives the okay, did some stretches, and he's staying in net.
He's staying in net.
Hopefully it does not change how he plays the rest of this game.
That's a real trooper, a real ice hockey player right there, staying in when you're injured. So we're going to see a face-off by the blue line, closer to Givorowski. That's only fair. And the captain, Ryan Long, will start us off with this second half of the third period. The crowd is cheering as anticipation awaits, and Ryder takes that draw. Ryder sends it into the neutral zone, looking to make a move as Ice Lines do excellent job with the forechecking. Long, inside, not able to get a stick on it, but gets it out to Owens. Back to the blue line. And it's kept by Bornesi, and over to Green. Green sends it back down in, and it gets lost, but picked up Ice Lines. Long, just not able to secure that shot. Still kept in by Green, and it goes off the pad of Givorowski. Ryder finally able to control possession, and they send it way back down. Here comes De Laurentiis looking for a pass, but it goes off the stick of Givorowski. Keeping it inside is the Ice Lines, but it trickles out. Now Ryder's making a play.
De Laurentiis is going to take this lost puck out from behind the net, looking for an opportunity. Good forecheck by Ryder, giving them a hard time to move to maneuver. And they enter the zone just like that. Nelson to a center slot, but it's blocked up by three Ryder players, and it's nothing can be made of it.
Ryder has been playing great defense on these centering passes.
And here we go again with Strobel, moving in with speed around the net, looking for an opportunity. Passed, shot, but it goes between skate or sticks. Not able to fully land their sticks on this one. Strobel's finally able to collect it, working his way down, but they're keeping up the pressure. Ryder finally takes that away and will make their counter strike. Big hit by Strobel, but both get up and seem to be fine.
That was a huge hit. Nice clean hit, no call, great hockey.
Ice Lions are carefully controlling the puck on their own side. And here we go into the neutral zone once again. Here comes Ryder. And Ice Lions are able to get it back out. Ryder dumps it in. And they're screaming off for Ryder, but they don't hear it. And here comes Connolly. Back pass, and now they enter the offensive zone. Connolly sticks it back to Duncan. Duncan with two shots, still go nowhere, and Giborowski covers up.
Good pressure by the Ice Lions right there to just keep getting shots towards the net. You're still looking to break the tie right now, try and not get an overtime game.
A little bit of pushing here too. See, Mayer's always involved in that one. All right, face off here off to the left of Giborowski, and Ryder's gonna take that one. But it looks like Ice Lions are gonna keep it in for a moment longer. Sent back down in, it slowly grazes into the pads. No one's able to make anything out of this. Puck goes on the boards. A little bit of a toss up with Duncan and one of the other players. And Ryder is now on a one-on-one. Let's see what he can do. He's making a move. He's going around and fair, and wasn't able to get a shot. And he collides into the boards.
On the other end of the ice, Padula and Duncan both still going at it in front of Giborowski. And the Ice Lions are on the offense.
Tied up against the boards. You see Alec Connolly now pushing forward. And that's going to be an offside on Duncan. Schumann just enters in, but Duncan just a little too quick there.
Ice Lions look like they're about to have a great offensive attack right there. Got over the line a little bit too early, and now we're outside of the blue line.
Sometimes you can just get too carried away and excited.
6:20 left in this third period. They're still looking to take the lead. Both teams fighting for this extra extension and get the lead.
Shots have become a little bit more distant. Ice Lions at 34, where Ryder's at 24 or 25. Ice Lions still have the upper advantage on offensive play as of right now. One by Ice Lions. Ice Lions will hold it in their own zone. Tanner Blacker sends it to neutral ice and it goes down. They're calling for icing, but they waved it. And Ice Lions are able to keep it in. Collins and Delino meeting at the boards, but Ryder's able to send it right back down. Ryder in their own zone, holding it there. Looking for a move, and they get it into the neutral zone at least. Sent back down, and Johnson will go reset. Johnson whiffs it, and Ryder's able to take that right away. Good forecheck by Ryder, this one player. Really disrupting their momentum of play, but Blacker was finally able to get that one out. Evelino takes it. Moving his way through, getting tag-teamed by three different players, and just like that, momentum has changed. Collins picks that up in his own zone. Sends it back down, and De Laurentiis beats it. He gets pinned against the boards, but he stands strong. Big pile up here, trying to get the puck out, and they send it around the boards, and it's picked up by Ryder. And we may have a penalty here.
Look, looked like they might have called a hand pass, so there'll be a face off in front of Givorowski.
Seems so. Oh, a little bit of a face off infraction here. And just like that, Givorowski covers up at the side of the face off.
Long has been involved in all of the skirmishes today, standing up for his team, now taking this face off. 5 minutes left. Both these teams fighting for something.
And it's still 2-2. Yeah. Who's going to win? Green tries to send it down, but it's intercepted by Ryder. Ryder's making headway, really being aggressive here, but good stick with Bornasi, and he's able to get it away.
Great defense by Ice Lines.
Picked up by Green, sends it over. Owens goes right back down. And Bornasi picks up in his own zone once again. Figuring out a move here. De Laurentiis makes a move right there into the neutral zone, still able to keep with the puck. Long to De Laurentiis, working his way around the net, and it goes right in front, and goalie's inside of the net.
Wraparound attempt, Givorowski just got there in time.
Here we go, the ice line, still in the center. Big pass and open ice here, now Ryder's going right back down the other way. Good tie up there, and it loses possession. And Long picks it up in the defensive zone. His rush, he's showing his speed still, working his way around. A shot, but it goes off the elbow of the goalie. Schumann meeting it. Looks like we have a high stick.
Yeah.
Read my mind.
Yeah, both these teams are fighting. Ryder, after starting the season 10-0, have been 4-3-2. And the Ice Lions are 10-0 at home. So both these teams, Long Ryder trying to get back on track. Ice Lions trying to keep that home ice advantage.
Nelson wins that faceoff, gets it back to the blue line for a shot, and they score! Nate Schumann, it looks like.
Givorowski did not see the puck off the rebound. He's going to want that one back, and the Ice Lions will take the lead with 3:48 left.
And I stand corrected. It is Justin Strobel. I'm not sure if that was a tip, but Justin Strobel seems to be the one who scored. Great job for that. And just like that, they're 3-2 with a final lead in this game.
He's been the big gnat in the face of Givorowski all game, and he finally gets that rebound he's been looking for, pushing in the back of the net.
Big excitement here. Let's see if they can hold Ryder off for the next 4 minutes. Ice Lines putting in the pressure in the offensive zone. Big hit there, and nothing to show for it. Justin Strobel with another shot, but nothing there as it goes wide. Here comes Nelson around the boards, back to the blue line. Stumps it back in, but no one's able to receive it. Picked up by Agan, sent down, but a blocker save can caught by Givorowski.
All right, and that goal came with 3:49 left, and that was the first goal tonight that was not on a power play.
Just about 3 minutes left in the period. Time is ticking very fast.
Ice Line still applying pressure. They want more.
For us, it may be going fast, but for the Ice Lines, this could not end sooner. Ryder picks that one up in neutral ice, and now they send it right back down for a dump-in. Ferry blocked that with his pads, and now Ice Lions are going to regather and see if they can get outside the zone quicker. Mayer with a long pass, and it goes down. It doesn't seem like they're going to call anything here. Big check, and Mayer picks it up once again. Against the boards, keeping it there. And Ryder takes that one, and they now leave the zone. Looking for a play here. Bad pass as Ice Lions intercept that. And now Ryder has to regather and recollect. But they make it in once again. Dumped in for a line change. And now the Ice Lions will pick up speed once again. Chasing it is Mayer, trying to beat him to it. But Ryder just unfortunately was just the better skater. Ryder in the neutral ice. Good move there, but wasn't able to stick with it. And that goes around the boards for Steve Evelino to pick up. And here he comes charging down the ice with speed, but just wasn't able to keep contact with the puck. Ryder with a good job throwing the body to get him away from the stick, or get him away from it.
Ice Lines have been great at wasting time. 2 minutes left. Ryder looking to pull their goalie. It can happen at any moment now.
It can, that's for sure. They're definitely going to need it.
Givorowski's looking at the bench.
And here we go. Ryder's trying to keep control of it so they can make that move. And the captain for Ryder is now going to take it in the neutral zone. Gavrowski's waiting. He's staying up top. But Iceland's gained possession, so it disrupts their play. They're showing aggression here. And it trickles back down into the defensive zone of the Iceland, and they're able to hold on to it. Here's Schumann being very careful with it. Sending it back, trying to waste some time here. Not a bad idea. Just about 1 minute left in the third period. Anything can happen. It only takes a second to score a goal.
Iceland's not giving Ryder a chance to pull their goalie to get that extra man on the ice.
Here we go with Ryder. Ryder's going down. They're really egging Gavrowski to come off, but he just doesn't think it's the right idea quite yet. Iceland is trying to make sure they don't have the possession long enough. Big hit there, and De Laurentiis goes down. And there's a goal. I'm sorry, I don't know who scored it, but it's now tied 3-3.
Great pressure applied by Ryder. With 45 seconds left, they get the equalizer goal. We could have another overtime game tonight.
It appears it was the alternate captain, number 12, TJ Evan, scoring that one. And just like that, just like yesterday, it's a tie game in the third period. There's a very good chance we are going to see an overtime, and then that's where it's going to be even more aggressive because there's a lot of open space with just three guys out on each team.
TJ Evans scores that goal on only the fourth shot of the period for Ryder. The Iceland's were out shooting them 10-4, had that 3-2 lead, and now with 45 seconds left, it's 3-3.
Little time out here as the coaches discuss what they're going to do with this next play. They're going to see if they can try to at least win it and not go into overtime.
I was surprised they did not try and get Gavrowski off the ice. There seemed to be two times where he could have gone off, but seemed to work out in their favor anyway. Ice lines.
He's really hanging in there.
The theme for the Ice lines these past two games have been adversity. How do they respond? Last night they responded great. It's 3-3 now, 45 seconds left to see what they do.
Shots are still in favor of the Iceland. 37-27, only a 10-shot gap. But it still shows who's being more aggressive. Buzzer sounds and they ask Ryder's players to come onto the ice. Puck is dropped and Ryder wins that one. Good forechecking here. By Iceland. Iceland are able to get in, but not for too long. Still in the neutral zone. It goes back down. Shoots it low, and Ferry's able to catch that one. Left, and Ryder has the advantage as they face off in the offensive zone. High shot. And Ferry catches that one again, so we'll see the face-off in the same spot.
Ferry has had a pretty solid game as the freshman, stepping up for his older squad. Let's see if he can keep this game at hand.
At this point, the goalies have the most pressure. And here we go on the blue line. Ryder keeps it in. Around the net, looking for an opening. That's two Iceland players. Keep it against the boards, trying to run the clock, it seems. Duncan takes it and dumps that back out in the neutral zone. It goes back down, collected by Tanner Blacker. And it is cleared. And that is the end of the third period. It does seem we will be going into an overtime. It'll be just like yesterday where it's 5 minutes of a 3-on-3. It'll happen really fast and you'll see a lot of shots. So looking forward to it. Maybe someone will actually score this time.
Yeah. 3-on-3, there's a lot of open ice. Anything can happen. And with how both these teams have been playing, it's about crashing the net. But also, Iceland's had two breakaways early on in this game and they were able to get one goal off of it shorthanded. Let's see if they hope to do that as well. And it's going to be interesting how Gavrowski's stamina is right now with being hurt early on in that period. Let's see if he can be still full strength.
Oh, it comes down to a full stamina game. If you can keep the puck in the enemy territory for long, the goalie's going to get tired out eventually. But the key is that you want quick shifts. You want to exert as much energy as possible and don't stay out longer than you need to. That goes for both teams.
Yes. Shots are 37-29 so far in this game. We're looking to see a lot more shots in overtime as well. 3-on-3, who do you look for? You had Mayer applying a lot of pressure.
I have.
Getting a lot of shots off.
I have Mayer, I have Leone, I have especially the captain, Ryan Long. He's probably the one that's keeping up most stamina. I see Long with a lot of intense speed this game. Even when it looks like he's tired, he just goes in with it. He exerts himself to the fullest. Same thing with Mayer. He's been throwing the body around. He's been trying to show everyone that he means business, and he's not afraid to get in your face and have the best net battle of your life. So I'm looking forward to seeing how these two players play in the overtime.
Also, throughout this game, Duncan and 27 on Ryder Padula have been going at it. They might have a little rivalry brewing.
Yeah.
3-on-3, there's a lot of ice, a lot of time to fight.
Let's see, maybe if it develops more, if we see something from those two players.
We'll see what happens.
All right, players are getting ready to start the face-off at center ice. But a little bit discussion with the bench of Ryder. Some nice communication in center ice between the two players, or the four players of the teams. Nice back and forth here.
A lot of pressure in this overtime. Iceland's looking to remain undefeated at home. Ryder looking to snap a three-game losing streak. Both teams got something to fight for. The discussion's still going on at center ice.
At the end of the day, it's just a fun way to get out and play the sport, and these boys know that, but they're still serious. They still want to win it for their team.
A ton of respect all around the ice, and it shows how they play.
Seems like players are going back to the benches for a little bit. Maybe we will not start with that quite yet.
Gavrovsky is the only player on the ice right now.
It does appear that we might be going into a shootout, maybe, right away. Nope, but the clock is set for 5 minutes, so it will be an overtime. Leone's gesturing to the ref to let's speed things up. They're very antsy to get out there and play.
So it was 5 minutes in overtime. Looks like they will start it out soon, so we might go for a quick commercial break. Be back.
Back, guys, we're about to start the overtime. It does appear. Ed, Leone are going to start first. Let's see how this works out. Puck is dropped, and Icelines will win that one. They will retreat in their own zone just to gather their thoughts and ideas. Here we go. They're sending it right back down. And we see them enter the neutral zone. With speed here, moving forward around the corner, looking for an open opportunity, and he wipes out behind the net. That is Leone. Ryder picks that one back up and changes momentum. They're going back the other direction. Being careful and smart with it, though, they now just enter the neutral zone. Working their way in through an offensive attack. Circles around. A shot, and it's saved just barely by Ferry. Covers that puck up real quick.
That one almost got away from Ferry. He did a great job getting his glove down and covering it up before Ryder got a rebound.
I was almost sure that was going in.
Yeah. Overtime is all about taking care of the puck and not giving it away in the neutral zone so the other team get a fast break.
Face-off won by Icelines, but Ryder's able to keep that in. Johnson is going around the net, and he's going to look for an opportunity here to start something. Here's Connolly. Waiting with it. Good move there, getting around. And Connolly's now going into the offensive zone with speed. Sends it back, but passes it right to a Ryder player, and now they take the advantage. One-on-one here, not that big a deal. Big check on the board by Connolly, and he goes down. And now Icelines take it the other direction. But Ryder takes that back, and now they're going to set up once again. Already really quick, a minute and a half that went through this period. This overtime period. And here we see Ryder enter the zone. They were looking for work and a really bad backhander. So nothing was made out of that. A shot and Ferry saves it right in his chest.
If I'm the Icelines right now, you gotta want this game to be over within the next 3 minutes and 26 seconds. Givorowski has saved all of your fast breaks so far. That's what a shootout is, so you gotta hope this game ends in overtime.
Karapandy yesterday was able to have the game-winning save. Let's see if maybe Ferry will too, if we have to go into a shutout or a shootout. There's Matt Owens collecting it around the boards to Mayer. Mayer looking for some potential here. He now enters the neutral zone with speed. Here comes Mayer. Good move there, but it's broken up by Ryder, and it's sent back down to Chase. And Ryder now has it. Ryder with a 2-on-1, a Ryder shot, and it just goes off Ferry's pad, and now it's picked up again by Mayer.
Good save by Ferry, not letting them get a rebound.
Then from the neutral zone, it goes down. It now jumps up. No offsides here. Owens with a good move. He's going for it. A backhander, and it goes wide. Mayer's now going to collect it. Sends it over to Ashford, but it just goes out behind the blue line, so they're going to have to reset, and that gives Ryder a good chance to change lineups.
Both teams looking to change lines.
Here we go. Icelines are going to start their offensive attack once again. Looking for a pass. He sends it up. He enters in. Here's Schumann. Schumann comes around the net, and Ryder's able to stick with them pretty well. Schumann throwing the body there, but Ryder's still making good moves into the neutral zone. Looking for an opportunity, a good dangle, but is broken up once again by De Laurentiis. Here we go with Icelines. Schumann once again looking for an opportunity, drops it back. A shot and an easy save by Givorowski.
Quick with the glove on the left side, good save, stops the play. 2 minutes left in this overtime.
A lot of shots from each side, but nothing was able to stick. Both goalies holding their ground. No one seems to want to budge. And just like that, only 2 minutes left in this overtime. Ryder's able to pick this one up, and they go behind the net. Passing it out. Long's trying to keep up with them. And now Ryder's making a speed dash for the goal. Getting around it is the captain. Going forward, but his stick poked away. Good poke check by the Icelines, and now they're able to take it on their turn. Here comes Bornazian. Bornazian around. He goes for a shot, and it doesn't go in, and it's just trickled out.
Givorowski looked behind him. He thought it snuck between his legs. It was about to get in. Good cover-up.
Very close call for Ryder. Ryder now takes it into the neutral zone, making the play here. Trying to get between two skaters, but sticks keep breaking that one up. off the body of Connolly. Don't know where the puck is. They keep scrambling. And now Ice Lions will reset.
Coming up on a minute left in overtime.
Here comes Long. Long looking for a smart pass, a smart play. Long, he's going to send it to Mayer. Mayer right there. He shoots, but it's off the blocker of Giveroski.
Got a little too close to the net. Didn't have a chance to get it towards the net. Good save by Giveroski.
Mayer decides to fall back and reset. Maybe get a line change here, and that's what they're going to do. Riders ahead of them, and they're able to play a defense once more. Here comes Owens. Owens straight down around into a centering slot, but it's missed. Mayer picks that one back up. He's still ready to go. He decided not to take a change. Sends it to Johnson. Johnson's going around the net, looking for an opportunity. Sends it back, and it goes wide, and they're going to have to chase it back down. And there's only 18 seconds left in this period. Ferry's going to hold on to it.
Ice Lions were just missing those centering passes by inches.
Johnson with one last attempt for a goal, and it gets taken by Ryder. Ryder comes around looking for an opportunity. Good dangle, a centering slot pass, and Ferry's able to cover it up, and there's no goal. Just good. 3 seconds left, exactly left in the period.
Great save by Ferry, remaining calm with that 2-on-1 push.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Game.
Really feeling the pressure.
Unless anything miraculous happens, it looks like we will have two shootout nights in a row.
It does seem like for this last 3 seconds, Ryder will pull the goalie for an extra skater, making it a 4-on-3.
3 seconds is enough time to get the puck across the ice. They want the Ice Lions win this faceoff. I don't know if I agree with that choice, but
we'll see. And they win it. It goes down, and just like that. Good call, not a good execution, and we will most likely go into a shootout once again. It's like deja vu from yesterday.
Yeah, yeah. If your heart can take it, get ready again. It went 5 rounds last night. Let's see how many it goes tonight.
Yep. Indeed. Will it be a quicker game? Will we go on even longer? But as the final countdown plays, we know we're coming up on the end of the game very shortly. But it's been tough. It's like middle of the season, just a little bit past. Each team's trying to make a name for themselves. They really want a good playoff spot, so they're trying to get every win that they can get.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, these are the games you have to win. I mean, it's a coin toss. You don't know what's going to happen, but it's now your best player versus the goalie. What happens now?
Yeah. Who will sneak by? Who will save the day? And we'll find out just shortly. At this point, it is a battle between Giveroski and Ferry.
Both goalies over 30 saves. Ferry has exactly 30, and Giveroski has 36 saves today.
Now, Ferry being a freshman and Giveroski being a senior, that's a pretty wide gap between skill sets, too.
Huge experience gap. Giveroski's been here before. This might be Ferry's first time. We'll see how the young guy handles it.
This is Ferry's first season. He's played a few games, but probably not as many as Giveroski. That is indeed a fact.
Both teams getting their lineups ready. We'll see who hits the ice first.
As the Ice Lions get their lineup ready, Kyle, who do you think the Ice Lions are going to put in as their first three?
First three, I really like how much pressure Mayer has been applying all
same
game.
Here.
He has been great. He has one of the goals. He scored the second goal to tie it up for the Ice Lions. I like him. Obviously, I like the captain, Long. He's been skating hard all game. And Delarantis, I mean, he's been great all game today.
I'd really like to see them put in Long. I think he's going to be their secret weapon. He's probably going to go third or maybe in the second round. We'll definitely see how that works out. But I think that from what I'm seeing is that Connolly is going to be the first up. Unless he was just talking to the goalie.
Ref's getting everything situated. We'll see who goes first. Puck is at center ice.
And indeed, it will look like it is Connolly. Connolly is going to take this first shot. Being very careful with it. He's able to take it with ease. Moving around. And a backhander, and he scores. Connolly, his first shot, and it's in. That's a good way to set the tone for this shootout.
Great patience by Connolly. Forward, backhand, and backhands it in on the left side. Sneaks it in between the posts.
It was a good stick handling. He was able to fake out the goalie pretty well. That's pretty experienced stuff. Now it looks like we'll have number 12, TJ Evan, alternate captain. He will take this for Ryder.
He has one goal today already.
Fans trying to get in his head and put on the pressure. Ferry meets him at the front, and it goes in. It goes over the shoulder. And just like that, it's 1-1.
Different approach by Evans with that. He wasn't with the stick handling. He picked his corner, and he shot it, got it in.
Both teams have delivered. And here we go with the ice lines. We're going to have Dayton Collins. He takes it in with speed, seeing if he's kind of get the ways around. And it's saved by Gibarowski.
It looked like he had a little mishandle right before he shot that, just had to get it off.
Still 1-1, but it's still anyone's game here. Number 26, Dominic Cercio. He will be taking this for Ryder as number 2. Smoothly takes it off the center ice. And a shot, it hits top shelf over Ferry once again, the weak spot, and now it's 2-1 in favor of Ryder.
That was a great move. He had a lot of patience getting that puck. He felt comfortable on the ice, and he just delivered for his team.
That's really intense. I'm not sure how many rounds they do. I think it's 3, but if Ice Lions can't deliver on this one, it'll be a game over. Here comes Owens. Owens making his way in, looking for a move. A shot, and he saves it, and that's it. Their first loss at home. Ice Lions lose in a shootout, 4-3, just like yesterday. But yeah, as Ryder is celebrating at the bench, it's just really unfortunate to see this long winning streak at home come to an end.
Yeah, you really felt like they had a huge advantage whenever they had home ice, and all teams seemed to be scared coming in, and now that that is over, we'll see how they perform.
There is nothing to fear. Exactly. There is nothing to fear, as there is a rematch next week to see if it's truly just a mix-up or if the Ice Lions really have a chance to prove that they can contend against this team. But that brings them back down to a 10-6 record. And that is all for today. I hope you enjoyed the game. Ice Lions played with their heart, but Ryder just played just a tad bit harder. We'll see you in a few weeks as we come on our few other home games. Yeah.